Hello, everyone. Larcenies is here, and welcome back to LXT Smackdown. Last week, we began our first week of LXT Smackdown as well as Raw. Raw came up yesterday, and you guys already know, just like I promised, today is Smackdown. So let's go down the list of the matches we have. Keep in mind any promotions I do. I just gotta do it myself. I think the computer's not smart enough to do it. Anyway, we got promotion. We got an opening promotion from The Miz. So I decided, hey, since he's opening the show, how about someone come fight him? So the first match is gonna be Shinsuke Nakamura versus The Miz. I think that's gonna be a great match. I don't know who's gonna win that one. That's gonna be a good one. Then next up is gonna be Alexa Bliss versus Asuka. This is me giving Asuka another chance because the first match she had, she wasn't impressive. Even though she got the victory, she didn't show me the powerhouse that my friend Alba Lord's been telling me about. Then next, we have Baron Corbin against Braun Strowman. Like I said, Braun Strowman is probably going to be in SmackDown for now. We keep him there. He looks like he fits. Baron Corbin, I've been hearing that he's been getting pushed. So, let's see how he does against Braun Strowman. Next match is going to be AJ Styles versus the Ayatollah of Rock and Roller, Jericho. I think this one's going to be a great match. Hopefully, these two live up to my expectations. And last, but definitely not least, a Falls Count Anywhere match between Dean Ambrose and Kevin Owens. As of these two matches, I can see pay-per-view status, but for now, I'm just letting Universe ride, because like I said, I don't have no rivalries as of yet, so I'm not sure what my pay-per-view is going to look like, so I'm looking forward to it. But like I said, we're going to start off with The Miz, and then from there, we're going to, pretty much you guys are going to see Miz and Shinsuke Nakamura starting the fight. So give me a second, guys. Okay, so we're back at The Miz. Unfortunately, I didn't even pick the promos. I actually forgot to put myself in there, and the computer did. He actually did a good job. So. Very impressed. So, pretty much the match is going like Shinsuke came in the ring. So, Larson's prediction, I'm going to say The Miz. I'm going to say The Miz is going to win. But, I do want Shinsuke to win. Shinsuke did have a great match last week in LXT. I believe it was Raw. That he had a great match with Neville. He had a great match with Neville. Sorry, I couldn't remember who it was. But he had a great match with Adrian Neville. And Adrian Neville did come out victorious. But it was a good match regardless. We did some improvements to Shinsuke, so he should be a little better, hopefully. He should be fighting like a little bit more aggressively. I didn't change none of his moves. I did change some of his stats. So he should have like more reversals. The fact that they're still fighting outside of the ring, as his count, is not good. Miz looks like he'll just go back in the ring, let Shinsuke not get back in. Maybe they both get counted out. I don't know. I don't know why he doesn't go back. I remember when they used to fear going. I remember they used to run in there by five. I wish they did that more. Oh my god, they're about to get counted out. Bringing it back into the ring. Oh, never mind. Holy crap. I was surprised. Close counter. I'm surprised Miz actually let Shinsuke end the ring and Miz win by countout. Because that's something I see the Miz doing. Maybe he couldn't beat Shinsuke. And he just... Oh. Gotta be the Miz. Actually, this is the first match I've seen with the Miz since I got the game. So I'm actually looking forward to see what kind of stuff he can do. Nakamura seems to have lost a step now. So I said, right now, The Miz is looking great. Shinsuke is still too early, so I don't want to say he has to change momentum, but is this right now favoring The Miz? These are two good matches. Like I said, I secretly hope Shinsuke wins, but I predict The Miz. Nice pickup.
A nasty kick there.
Shinsuke trying to get under his opponent's skin with this one. Drop kick? Or a spinning wheel kick? That's it. Drop kick. Alright, cool. That was a nice little drop kick. Actually connected, unlike some people that miss. Sami Zayn. Yeah. Hopefully Shinsuke keeps being aggressive. He looks like he's changing the pace. That's good. Yeah, I like Shinsuke. I think he's a great wrestler. I think he's interesting. I'm a little afraid in real life when he goes into WWE because I believe that they won't forget about him. Like, the case has been there with a lot of characters that were good in NXT and then just been forgotten. So who knows what they do with Shinsuke. Shinsuke powering out really early. Pin like now you like barely even a two count, not even take one. These two are actually like even in a technique, which I'm actually impressed. Like reversing each other moves, and Shinsuke right now looks old. Never mind, I thought he was gonna get the better moves of the map, the move of it. Ooh, nice. Ooh, right outside the ring again. It's getting a little personal. Like I said, me personally, I just... Alright, thank you for going back in the ring. I'm surprised Miz is actually put him in the ring instead of Shinsuke. But like I said, Miz is the heel in the game. Again, outside. I think it's like a unique exit, too. That's not a normal exit, so I think it's only Shinsuke could do that. So I think so. Wow, Shinsuke looks like a heel in this one. he's just beating the crap out of Miz outside. He doesn't really care about inside. But never mind. Nice little strikes. Shinsuke doing a lot of damage. Not a lot of damage, but him throwing him out there countlessly does a little damage over time. Like I said, since game though, I know he's glitched because the AI is retarded sometimes. And though they want to go for the turnbuckle, but they just not smart enough to know that. That's it. There's like a...
Nice.
Ooh, looks like Miz might try to end it right now. Oh, nice. Okay, reversal.
He gets out of trouble there.
Shinsuke changing around. I don't know who's. I hope Shinsuke wins, but. So my predictions are now, 50-50. Depends on who AI is smarter.
Now he just wants that insult injury. Yeah,
ooh, nice.
Mean streak. He's showing no signs of letting up.
What the hell is this? Okay, I've never seen that. That's a unique powerbomb. By Shinsuke. I thought he was going to reverse the kick into something else, but
you can practically feel
that was actually pretty good. I'm not going to lie. No drop kick? Ooh, why? The hell? Sorry for being so loud. I just didn't expect it to be on mid turnbuckle. Ooh. Wow, I can see that happening.
That's how you put away an opponent.
Let's see what happens. One, two, oh, nice. Almost two count, not even close to three, but still close enough that I maybe thought it was over, but that shin, the kielbasa in the second rope, that surprised me more. I didn't know he had one. Maybe, I thought it was a turnbuckle running hit, not like a like actual turnbuckle hit. I thought he was good for a drop kick. Ooh, looks like Miz took the upper hand. I'm not sure how it changed so fast, but ooh! Shinsuke's bleeding. Wait, did it say the Miz? Oh, they came with game glitch. I think they said the Miz when it meant Nakamura. Nice reversal from Shinsuke. Like I said, I'm deep down. The Miz wins, I can't get mad. Like I said, this is a good match right now. This is really good. Surprising. Very surprising how it's going. Ooh, nice. I'm just surprised he got the super backflex. That's really interesting. Oh, no, it's not suplex. Oh, German suplex. Ooh, that looks ugly. Not like, that looked like it hurt a lot. Looked like the blood that she made. She just getting more aggressive. Kind of like with Bray Wyatt with DX. No, was it Bray Wyatt? Bray Wyatt and R-Truth and Goldust. Oh. The Miz is showboating. He's glowing like he would. He turned the tables very easily. I like this match right now. It's going. They're playing. They're both even. They're both very even. I don't know who's gonna win. Nice aggressiveness from the Miz. Shinsuke might be caught again with another Skull Crusher finale. Ooh, what the hell is the finger four? Okay. I didn't know he got the finger four as a submission. Why are you waiting? Why? My question is, why the hell did he pick him up just to put him in his finger four? Ooh, Shinsuke. Never mind. I know he's not gonna tap out because I'm like, pretty sure he could damage the leg a little bit more, but not bad from Shinsuke. Thank God the game's not retarded. You know, just because you beat, well, even though it should be like that, you beat the guy up enough. Maybe a leg submission could not. Ooh, nice clothesline. It looks like he might be over. I thought he was gonna pick him up. I thought it was awake on top. Ooh, Shinsuke. Maybe Miz showboating a little too much. Looks like he's changing the tables. Nice aggressiveness. Shinsuke, looks like he's going for another turnbuckle kielbasa. This might be over. Ooh, nice. Love it. Pin him, please. Oh, I look like something he'll do. Like, he does a kielbasa in the mid row. People get crazy. Oh, is this like a regular move? It looks like it. Oh my God, three. Kill. Oh man, that is. I think Miz is undone. One, two, three. Nice. And Shinsuke. Good match. I'm so happy Shinsuke won. I was wrong, but damn, that was a good match. Holy crap. The Miz actually did really good. It was that kielbasa from the second broke. It looks really brutal, man. Like, this is the end of it here, right here. Blah! Just 1, 2, 3. Shinsuke Nakamura defeats The Miz. Even though The Miz had a great promo, it was not enough to defeat the man of strong style. Let's see what was next. I forget. I think it's the girls. Yep. Asuka versus Alexa Bliss.
Versus Asuka.
Larson predictions. Obviously, Asuka. Because my friend Abla predicts that she's the beast. I want to see if the game actually portrays that beastness that she is. So, let's just see. Two A's against each other. Nice. These two just started off aggressively. I was waiting for my cameraman to come up there, but he didn't come. Ooh, Alexa Bliss, a nice little tackle. Like I said, he didn't miss much, just like a few strikes from Asuka. A nice angle. Yeah. I said, Abloy tells me that this girl's like the Goldberg of females. Like, she's just monsters. I want to see WWE can portray the fact that she's undefeated, the fact that she's current NXT champion, I want to believe. Well, women's NXT champion, I should say. I forget what's that called, the Divas champion, maybe. Ooh! That looked like it hurt more than it should. She went to the ropes and it didn't look like it was the ropes were kind to her. These two are battling out pretty good, aggressively. Them showing some technical skills. Nice little power slam.
That's the first time tonight we've seen that move. I wouldn't mind seeing it a little.
Nice aggressiveness from Asuka. Asuka's just, oh my God, her submission looks painful. don't think that's an offense, right? Oh, she got out real quick. Maybe that's a good thing, because he looks like that little way hurt. Hell, I look like, I ain't gonna lie, I probably tapped out of that. Ooh, Asuka. Ooh, showing some nice aggressiveness. She's not showing me the same fine. She's not being the same Asuka I saw last time. Last time, she just got beat. Like, she got beat to a pulp. And she, even though she won, it was like, I felt like she could have lost if the match was longer. So I'm looking forward to that. Ooh, nice reversal from Alexa Bliss. We're going to call it A for now. Okay, I'm getting tired of saying A. Asuka's a more important female. She's the dominant female. She is the Goldberg. Ooh. What the? Ooh, nice little. Out of nowhere. There's only one count. Asuka doesn't even look like she's surprised, honestly. Ooh, showing some aggressiveness. Ooh, I think it might be over. Asuka's been the dominant one right here. Submission hold. Ooh. Alexa Bliss does not look like she's in a happy place. She's tapping or she's gonna fight out of it. Ooh, she's in there for a long time. Ooh, tap out, nice. Asuka quickly demolishes. Ooh, I thought Asuka was gonna continue beating her up. I'm like, oh, okay. That was actually a quick, easy domination from Asuka, showing me that Ablo was right, you know, I prediction was right, and that she showed that, ooh, she just rolled out the ring. Very impressive from Asuka. That's the person I want to see. Aggressiveness, relentlessness, that was actually a quick match. It was like, what, 3 minutes? Holy crap.
We got one-on-one action coming your way next, King.
Baron Coleman.
It's Baron Corbin against Braun Strowman.
That's gonna be an interesting. I don't
wait to
know.
See these two go at it.
Larcenies predictions. Braun Strowman. But like I said, these two have been getting a great push from WWE. So let's just see what's happened. So these two are gonna fight up after these commercial breaks. My name is Larcenies, and I'm here to stop hackers. Hackers, as we know, such as this one right here. 8 bits per play. This guy, you know, even he misspelled his name. He doesn't even know that he misspelled his name. Come on. That screams hacker. So make sure you go by 8 bits per play. You tell him that Larcenies thinks he's a hacker, that he's not worthy of playing with me anymore, because he just cheats, man. It's not fun, man, when people cheat. So it's not fun. 8 bits per play. He ruins the play.
Tonight should be extremely.
Thank you for the commercial breaks, Larcenies. Yeah, we'll make sure to check out that guy, 8 bits per play, and make sure to give him what we think. So, as I said, this match started. Baron Corbin ran for running DDT that everyone has, apparently. And that was usually exclusive to Kane and Undertaker, but whatever. And like I said, my prediction is Braun Strowman. But like I said, I never seen none of these two actually fight in the ring. Like, physically in the WWE. So I don't know. I hear Braun Strowman is like a. Yeah, last time he had a match, it was against Big Show. And he was like, he's actually being like a cruiserweight. So I love the fact that people like him and Luke Harper are like so athletic. Even though the size difference is amazing. Baron Corbin right now is looking like a looking like aggressive, being the hell out of Braun Strowman very aggressively. Like I said, it's still early. Ooh, nice power from Braun Strowman. Braun Strowman actually in the game is actually extremely powerful. He's actually like when I was editing his stats, he was his strength was actually maxed out, which is actually impressive. I'm talking about like 100. So that's impressive. That's like Cesaro or Goldberg level of power.
That hurts.
So I want to see if the WWE, I said, obviously knows what they have here. I want to see how they use him. Hopefully they just don't forget about him like they normally do. What Braun Strowman needs in WWE real life, he needs someone like Paul Heyman. He needs a hype man. He doesn't have charisma, so he needs someone to give it to him. Like, I said Bray Wyatt, but Bray Wyatt's the right now current champion. And, he doesn't want to, you know, you don't want to downgrade Bray Wyatt just yet. Well, not downgrade, but, like, you don't want Bray Wyatt, you know, he's important. So, he has a belt, he has to do his own thing, but he needs a hype man. Braun Strowman needs someone to be the voice, and he be the strength. So, like I said, someone like Paul Heyman, someone like that has a very good mic skills, and Braun Strowman can just do the rest. That's what Braun Strowman needs. Like, and then I think, like I said, if he has like a Paul Heyman, he could be like a very... Oh my god, that's something Braun Strowman would do. I could see that. I don't know him, but I could see him just decimating people. Oh, Brian Coleman, nice reversal. I think, yeah, Brian Coleman is very wisely going in the ring. Doesn't want to deal with Braun Strowman outside. Yeah, I think the outside does more damage, obviously, but I'm not sure if it's that. I don't know if that's implicated in the game, so I don't think so. But who knows? Ooh, right, aggressively the minute Braun Strowman gets in, Brian Coleman easily, as wisely puts him down. Sacrifice got raised his technical skills because, as I said, I heard he did like a kick up, so I want to see that. I gotta look on YouTube and see that out. Ooh, nice aggressiveness. I said, oh, for record, I also changed his special, so he doesn't have he doesn't have that submission hold no more. Even though I think that was something that he used to do that for my friend. He said that now he does like some type of power slam. So I didn't know what power slam he had, so I kind of gave him like a military plus. Ooh, nice DDT. Impressive. I didn't even see that coming, but like I said, I changed his finisher to power slam, so it looks like something he will do for the amount of power. God, he is changing the momentum. He is beating the hell out of Brandon right here. God, I feel sorry for him a little bit. I really don't. Ooh, nice counter. I don't think you want to really. Feeding off the adrenaline of Baron, of Braun Strowman. That was really close, actually. That was extremely close. I didn't know what... I was closer than I thought. I didn't think that was... Look at this. Ooh. Baron Coleman looks like he's about to signal the end. That was a close two count, so it might be over. Ooh, nice. Might be over. One. Two. Ooh, Braun Strowman kicking out. Nice. Like I said, I don't know. Like I don't know Baron Corbin. That was actually a very impressive finisher. I like that. That was good. Why does everyone do that? I hate that. Ooh. Braun Strowman showing just a pure aggressiveness. Not like... He's not. It's not pretty. It's just... He gets the job done. Ooh, nice powerbomb. Disgusting. This is disgusting, but not like in a horrible way. Oh my god, another one? Ooh. Showing the power. Braun Strowman just aggressively. Oh. Baron Coleman luckily just reverses whatever would happen. Baron Coleman wants this to end. You can see that now. He does not want to face Braun Strowman right now. He is trying to change the momentum. Ooh, Braun Strowman with power. Such technique. God, ooh, I love it.
We haven't seen that one tonight.
Braun Strowman showing the dominant force that he is and that he is in the WWE currently. Being a, ooh. Everyone has that damn DDT. Like, what the hell? Like, that was exclusively for like Rock and Shane, but you know, who needs them, right? They're nobodies. Nice knee, nice aggressiveness from Braun Strowman. Braun Strowman just flat out just fighting. So I love it. I love the fight that they're doing. Ooh,
He's still very much in this thing. But John, this guy's such a gamer.
Let's see what this. This is a good. That's actually a pretty good match. Like I said, it's showing the Braun Strowman is a just. This is the finisher that I put gave him. Like I said, something he will do. Power slam. Ooh, it might be over. One, two, three. Very impressive, Brandon. But God, Braun Strowman looking just aggressive. Pure aggressiveness. Not the same man I saw fight Dean Ambrose. Even though, man, I'm not gonna lie, damn, Braun Strowman was close. I didn't think it was so even, but yeah, Braun Strowman showing that power, showing aggressiveness. This is relentlessly attacking Baron Corbin, so that way he just didn't have any aggressiveness towards him. Like I said, the match favorite. I predicted right, and Braun Strowman wins with his new finisher. So that's it. Hopefully something. I'm gonna call my friend Albert Lloyd. He's gonna see this match and he'll let me know if it's actually a good old finisher for him. Why do you keep mixing up Ultimate? Goddamn. Like I said, very impressive. From Braun Strowman. Very impressive. I look forward to your match. We'll give you a week off. Maybe show some Luke Harper now. But that was impressive. Very good match. Very good match.
Up next, John, we have singles action.
Ooh, this is going to be a great match. Chris Jericho versus AJ Styles. Don't know. Let's say for now, AJ Styles. But like I said, right now, it could be anyone's game. So let's just go in there.
Thank you for choosing to spend your evening
and
with us.
Let's just see. As always, I predict AJ Styles, but if Jericho wins, it's not an upset. I said Jericho's that wild beast that is, he's a main eventer. He's a mid card. He's something that everyone has to be. He's the mid card. He could play any field. He could be the mid card. He could be the main eventer. Currently, Jericho has a gimmick that everyone loves right now with the whole list and him with just like the whole list and the whole acting like a stoner thing. I think people loving him right now. That's great. I think that he deserves it. Like I said, Jericho's always been a good wrestler for me. Entertaining the mic, entertaining the ring. That's how you gotta be. AJ Styles, though, no slouch. I said AJ Styles is gonna be very big in WWE. So I'm looking forward to seeing this match. I really hope these two show everything they have. Oh, nice. AJ Styles aggressively showing the athletic skills that he has against Chris Jericho. Like I said, Chris Jericho also has like a lot of athletic ability too, so don't sleep on him.
He's still got plenty of gas left in his tank though. Mago, we're going to see what this guy this is made of.
I really hope this is the match tonight. So far, the match tonight, I'd probably say Braun Strowman and Baron Corbin. That's it. They both were very impressive. The match was very, it could have been anyone's game. Also, Shinsuke Nakamura and The Miz was actually a good match too, so I'm not sure. But let's see. Let's see if this one can top it. And like I said, we still have, this is not even the main event. That's the beautiful part. The main event for LXT is definitely Dean Ambrose versus Kevin Owens. So that's not a slouch either. That's two big main eventers. I'm looking forward to seeing that match. Quick pin from AJ Styles. Chris Jericho didn't even close just that one count, and that's it. It's not even close to two.
Jericho's skill set is as fast as anyone I've ever seen.
Nice. Focusing on that arm.
Match speed and aerial attacks with luchadors. Grapple with wrestling.
Ooh, nice. I don't even know what that was. Was that elbow or a knee?
He can outthink strategist.
It looked like he hit him with the knee, but it looked like he tried to do a diving elbow. So we're just going to assume that he did a diving elbow. Ooh, Jericho finally changes the momentum. AJ Styles is there for a while, and now Jericho's changed the game. Unfortunately, doing a stupid rest hold that everyone fucking fights out of. And there you go.
But he's very aware of who he's in there with. And what he has to do to
the same thing the Miz has,
and at this point,
right
it
there.
Looks to me like this match
that's not something you
want to
do with AJ
get.
Styles.
I think a lot of people
but
would
he surprisingly didn't
John,
get punished
for
that.
Sake, I hope there's a lot more left in the tank.
Problem?
You know, Cole, we've seen it time and time
again. Powerbomb, nice.
Jericho uses his mastery of psychological warfare.
I wasn't sure what he was going to do. Could have been something else.
Then he uses his physical skills to kick the...
Nice clothesline. Nice kick to the back from AJ Styles. These two are slow. I said, Chris Jericho changed the momentum, but it was very short. It looks like he's, I don't know what they call it, but it's definitely a reverse, like a, like a go to sleep, but not really go to sleep. Ooh, nice moves from AJ Styles. Ooh, that's kind of like an insult a little bit. That's like, that's the line, that's what the hell is that called? Oh, it looks like he's about to go for that forearm. Is it over, really? From Jericho now? Ooh! Chris Jericho reverses the forearm. He said he's not that over. Very impressive from Jericho. Didn't honestly see that coming. I thought it was it. Ooh, nice aggressiveness from Jericho. Change the momentum. I kind of wish AJ Styles was a little bit more in the... I mean, Jericho was in the middle when he tried to do the... When he tried to reform, I think he's gonna do the balls of Jericho or maybe the code breaker. Who knows? Oh, AJ Styles may have reversed the code breaker, probably. I'm not sure. Pretty sure. Oh, another signature here. Nice hit to the back of that. Oh, damn, these two are doing good. I like it. Ooh. Reversals from both AJ, from both Jericho. Nice powerbomb. Powerbomb pin. Ooh, rope break though. Referee saw the rope. Wisely, AJ Styles going for another forearm. Let's see if he can actually hit with this one. Ooh, he missed. He missed because the AI is stupid. So does that count? Because he didn't connect, and Jericho technically never reversed it. So does he have another one in the tank? Can the game actually be wise enough, smart enough to do it? The game is actually wise enough to do it. Oh, thank you. That might connect this time. Oh my god. Two times in a row, this game missed with the foreign elbow. How is that even possible? I've seen it connect. It's connectable. Still in the middle ring, like you just go on the opposite before. Side, you idiot! Don't stop going so close to Jericho. Like, I think the game should have like all. I think this would be a good. This should hit. Should. There you go. Third time's a charm. We're gonna just assume they down a 1, 2, 3. Wow, impressive victory from AJ Styles. Larson's prediction was right. AJ Styles of impressive victory against Jericho. Jericho honestly was getting beat up in that one. I'm a little mad that AJ Styles missed two times with the foreign. I don't know. He missed a lot with that foreign that forearm. But that's it. The third time was a charm. He won with the 1-2-3. Impressive. Very impressive for AJ Styles. Very big victory. Very, very impressive. Very, very impressive. AJ Styles, I predicted you, and I'm happy you won. But the main event, Falls Count Anywhere, Dean Ambrose, and Kevin Owens.
Kevin Owens. Whoa, this
I predict
nominated for a slammy.
This is actually a great match right here. I don't know who's going to win. I don't care who wins. That's a perfect thing. I believe Kevin Owens. I think he's going to win. Dean Ambrose does have a victory against Braun Strowman, though. Keep that in mind. So remember that. But this main event is going to be up after these commercial breaks. Now rise up. My name is Larcenies, and this is how the real colony lives. Unlike Robert Rewind, we got stuff taken care of. So just remember that. When you watching that the other side, when you just feel sorry for them, just remember, there's a colony that's always doing something better. And his name is Larcenies. Thank you for those commercial breaks, Larcenies. We know how damn, man. Dean Ambrose quickly going for weapon. That's something I see him do. What the hell happened to that sledgehammer? Okay, let's just assume that sledgehammer just got thrown out from the referee side, okay? Thank you. But thank you for those commercial breaks, Larcenies. We will check out that Rimworld series because we know that other side lives better. You know. Oh, quickly just going for the weapon. Not. If those, I guess false count anywhere, it does mean, it's like another different, version of stream rules. You know what I remember I missed the wrestling games did? I missed when they actually had weapon physics. That was a beautiful time. Remember that, guys? When the WWE actually cared about the weapons and when people did certain moves on the weapons, they actually break? Oh, man. That felt like centuries ago now. Yeah, but God damn, it feels like forever. I said these two are aggressively just looking for the weapons. They do. I said it's not gonna be pretty. These two, I expect this type of match. Like Kevin Owens looks like a type that loves to just go for weapon. Ooh, nice hit from Dean Ambrose. Dean Ambrose is no stranger to foreign weapons. Remember, it can also pin outside the ring, so this is all legal. That's a first. So the referee it's not like this extreme. I guess extreme rules in false count anyway is different because extreme rules is like use weapons, but you got to pin inside the ring, which makes some stupid sense. In false count anywhere, you can just fight anywhere, but you know this game. I doubt they go anywhere further than this.
Ambrose starting to struggle now.
So nice, I don't know what exactly what he's getting. That was, but Kevin Owens, Dean Ambrose is very even right now. As these two continue to fight outside, this is going to do a lot more damage, especially that powerbomb. I would say this is not even close to a two count. Dean Ambrose showing a lot of freshness, a lot of aggression. Ooh, God. That's a nice close-up right there. Intentional winning the match inside the ring. All this time on the outside doesn't appear to be doing him any good. Nice little elbow from Kevin Owens. Showboating, fans going, booing fans, Kevin Owens. There's a lot of people don't like him personally, but I think he's cool. Oh, there you go. Nice. Are they actually going to go outside? That'd be impressive. Oh, I'm going to say Dean Ambrose. Trying not to let Kevin Owens dominate the match. These two are cameraman's having a little Kevin. Oh, nice clothesline. Cameraman looks like he's having problems. Could just easily adjust, but you know, whatever. I remember when I used to do the weapon physics. Thank you, because I think the camera angle was actually making my game. Ooh! Lag. Oh, no, man.
Can he end it quickly? If the referee counts.
I'm going to say, where the hell is it going?
And the shoulder gets up in time.
I just sure took forever. And can you guys find a different location that doesn't involve my cameraman slash lag dropping to like a bazillion to like -2? It's definitely not bad. It's just like, I guess because the angle that the camera is, it just makes it a lot more difficult for the frames to like rough hold somehow. Maybe because of rendering like all the audience and all that stuff. So, outside.
Pressure a bit, and on top of that, he's been spending a lot of time outside the ring during this match. You have to wonder what the strategy is here.
Oh, they're going. Remember, the referee can count out here, so let's see what he does.
Get opportunities to shine here in the WWE.
What is Dean Ambrose doing?
The old adage is, a win's a win.
Oh, where the hell are they going? I don't think Dean Ambrose knows what it
is. A reversal from Ambrose. Oh, that was slick. Dean Ambrose is really going to town right now.
Dean Ambrose is wildly swinging. Seems like something he'll do. He just doesn't care what he's doing. These two are just outside the ring. Like, can they even go up more? Oh, they're going. Oh, they're going. Oh, yeah, they're going up. I'm going to say Kevin Owens. Yeah, it looks retarded right now, but no way. It was just me. Yeah, actually, by the. Oh, they punch. Kevin Owens aggressively. Oh, never mind. Oh, aggressively attacking these people. Oh, back suplex. Oh, backbreaker. Never mind. That does a lot of damage outside the ring. All these things they're doing, it's not going to be pretty. These two are just aggressively beating the hell out of each other. I love it. So these two are fighting outside the ring. Oh, they're by, I know where they are. They're by, like, almost the ring. But they're not there yet. Ooh. Dean Ambrose, blood on the face. That may be actually helping because Dean Ambrose looks like the type to just go crazy when blood. Yeah. Oh, look, I told you. Ooh, quickly reverses whatever. Oh, nice dirty D. Oh, referee come out of nowhere. Even though he was in. Ooh, nice dirty D. Quick match from Dean Ambrose and Kevin Owens. The ring, I said the outside was the favor. That DDT outside did a lot of damage to Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens didn't see the light of day, and it was just all over. But that was the main event. That was quick. That was actually another quick match. Well, that's it for Raw. I mean, SmackDown. LXT, is it me or Dean Ambrose looks super buff when he lifts his like shirt, when he lifts his arm up? That's crazy. But yeah, Dean Ambrose, press a victory against Kevin Owens. No slouch. Kevin Owens, don't worry, you'll get a shot next time to redeem yourself against Dean Ambrose. But for now, that's it for LXT SmackDown. I hope you guys enjoyed what you saw. If you did, you know what I said, hit that like button. It means a lot to me. It shows that you appreciate the series. Keep in mind, this series is going to be every Thursday for SmackDown and every Wednesday for Raw. Just in case you guys are curious, I'm going to be off camera. I'm going to edit this match card, so don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. I think it's the same shit as always. So I'm going to edit this, and we're going to have some different matches. We're going to put some new people, some new faces, so everything's going to change for this one. So I hope you like to see. I'll see you in the next LXT.